The turn of the cart can mean fortune and fame, but that all depends on your luck in the game. On Card Shark! And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim.
Are you the school marm?
Hello there.
Thank you, Dad. Thank you for joining us on Card Shark. Delighted to have you here. You're very kind.
You're a nice group.
And we want to thank for the opening poem Harry J. White of Baltimore, Maryland, or as they say there, Balmer. Balmer, Maryland. Thank you, Harry. Let's open up the board and get to the cards. Go ahead. And Janice Alonis will load in the cards, and we'll meet our card sharks. Hello there, Linda Wayne, our champion. Let me get the microphone here. All righty.
Okay.
You're all set?
Yep.
Campy is here with you. Hi, Campy.
Back there.
Campy's... I didn't ask you, Lynn. How long has Campy been with you?
He's been... I've had him for 4 years now, and he's 5 and a half. And he's really a very smart dog.
Oh, I have to, yeah.
There's only one thing I haven't been able to get him to do yet, though.
What?
Find me a good-looking guy.
Oh, right. Is there any single fellas out there who want a lady who is much richer, $1,450 since she came here?
Fantastic.
Right. Campy smart, and you're cute. You won't have any troubles.
Thanks.
Our challenger is Barrie Dunn. Hi, Barrie. Nice to see you again. Our friend from Canada. Good to have you here. I didn't ask you, now, what do you do specifically in Halifax?
Well, it's actually, that's where I live, but I work with cooperatives, and most of them are along the Eastern Shore. There's fishermen's co-ops and farmer's co-ops. There's all kinds of things like that.
Oh, yeah, and that's a lovely country where you come
beautiful.
From. Halifax is a beautiful area there in Nova Scotia. I recommend anyone going there for a visit.
Yes, indeed.
Happy to have you spend part of your time here with us.
I'm
nice
delighted.
To visit. Both of you are good players. And, of course, we left off in the last show in kind of a tense moment because we play the best 2 out of 3. We are tied at 1-1, and now you've both cut the cards, I know, at the beginning of that match. That means we are going to have the tiebreaker right now. We've got it set up with just... 3 cards up there, 3 questions here, and as we left off, the question, Linda, goes to you.
Okay.
Linda, we sent our man on the street to Japan, where he asked 100 married women, when your husband enters a room, do you bow? How many Japanese women said when their husband enters the room, they do bow?
Well, I think that custom still tends to hold true, but not as much as it did before. The new ideas from the West are coming in. I think that's going to be kind of a medium-low number, probably 31.
31 out of 100 Japanese married women bow. Higher or lower, Barrie?
I am pretty sure that the custom is still in there in Japan. I'm going to say it's a little bit higher.
Higher than that?
Yeah, I think so.
If it's higher, you'll get first crack at the cards. If not, it'll be Linda with hers. Hit the answer right on the head. It's a $500 bonus. The actual number of Japanese women who said when their husband enters the room, they bow is... 3. That's all. Linda, you've got it. The times have changed. Linda, with just 3 cards up here, you're starting with an ace.
Oh, lower.
Lower than the ace. Another ace. Not lower, and a big break for Barrie. A free chance.
Oh,
and a king.
Okay. A king. Let's go lower than
lower
the king.
Lower than a king. A 9.
A freeze.
He freezes on the near middle card. Barrie needs 1 card. We'll fill in the spaces for you, Linda. You need 2 cards. Still, control could be very, very important. Barrie, one of the most popular books in recent years was called Looking Out for Number 1, and it explained how and why a person should take care of himself first. So we asked 100 psychiatrists. Generally speaking, do you think most people today care too much about themselves and too little about others? How many psychiatrists do think people today are too selfish?
I think when we went through the 70s, I think we called that the me decade, and I think we just did go a little bit too far about thinking about ourselves. I'm going to say that that's a high number. I will say 57.
57 out of 100 say yes, we are too selfish. Psychiatrists, higher or lower, Linda?
Well, that's kind of an in-the-middle number. You give me a lot of help there. I think it's probably lower.
Lower than that. You really think that people are not as selfish anymore?
Yeah.
All righty. Or you choose to hope they're not as selfish.
I hope they're not.
57 and lower. The actual number of psychiatrists who think people today care too much about themselves is 82. Not lower, much higher. They are much too selfish, they say. Barrie, you've got a 9.
Yes, I want to change that card, please, Jim.
And the 9 becomes a 2.
Higher.
If this is higher, we have a new champion.
Yes,
3. Barrie wins it. to say goodbye to Linda. Barrie, our new champion, will play the market. Linda, got to say goodbye. You are leaving us with $1,450. Listen, I want to say something. I know you didn't want... You wouldn't want to be treated any different than anybody else, and you shouldn't. But I tell you something. You did a lot of people a lot of good to realize that people... You don't have to be treated any different than anybody else. You give people half a chance, it's amazing what people can do. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
You're a fine champion. Linda Wayne. We'll be right back with Barrie and the Money Cards right after this. Back with our new champion, Barrie Dunn, and you deserve to be here because you did defeat a very good champion.
She was excellent.
Linda's very, very sharp. Yeah. People who are with us the last couple of shows know that Linda says she listens to the show every day and enjoys it, and that it was obvious the way she played it. Sometime, love to have you come down and join us. Right now, Barrie has, all the way from Halifax. You cut the cards?
Yes, I did.
Let's see if we can make some money. Those airline tickets are expensive. Come on, Barrie, hop up here. Here we go. $200 of new money, three cards on the bottom line. Your decision how you bet them. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money and three more cards. Minimum bets, $50, till you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must risk at least half the money. Right. Good luck, Barrie.
Thank you, Jim.
And remember, you don't lose with a double over here. You're on your own. Want to give you every opportunity. Here's $200.
Okay.
You can change the base card if you need to. Thank you, Lois. We'll start Barrie with $200. And a two.
Oh, wonderful. All of it higher.
Right, for $400 if this card is higher than a two.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I don't like that nine. I'm just going to say $50 lower.
Yeah, $50 lower than a nine?
Oh.
No, with a queen.
Okay, well, that's
$350 and a queen.
All of it lower.
He's going to risk it all. $350 if this card is lower. And it is.
Oh.
Took a chance, paid off, $700. We'll move up to seven and give you the other $200.
Yes, Jim, I'd like to change that seven, please.
With $900, the seven becomes...
Ooh,
the middle of an eight.
That's not good. Okay, I'm going to be very conservative. $50 lower than the eight.
Yeah, we've seen one high, one low.
Yeah.
He says lower for $50. Great trade, though, $50 for an
eight. Yeah, that's great. All of it lower.
And a double, $850. Yes,
oh!
Three. $1,700 and a three.
Now, this is where it gets tricky. $1,200, that it's higher than that three.
$1,200 higher than a three.
No.
But you don't lose with it. You don't lose. Remember now, you don't lose on the double. You still have a great card. Now we move it up. Still with $1,700. Do you still have confidence in it?
I am going to bet $1,200 that it's higher than that three.
Come on. He's going to stay with the $1,200. This time you better be right. Is this card higher?
Yes!
$2,900. I take a lot of guts to stay with it like that. Way to go, Barrie. Come on down. Well, that'll pay for the trip.
I guess I'm
$200 in the game. That's $3,100 for Barrie Dunn, our visitor from Canada. We'll be back with a new challenger and a new match right after this. All right, Barrie. Janice is dealing out two brand new decks of cards. Pick up the new challenger on Card Sharks. Carol Kinnock. Hello, Carol. Nice to meet you. Nice to have you here.
Nice to meet you, too.
And what about Carol Kinnock?
Well, my name's Carol Knopp, and I originally come from Sacramento County in a little place called Orangeville, but now I'm living on the UCLA campus in one of the dorms, and I love to travel and modeling, and I love pageantry, and I was a 1979-80 Miss Teen California. And
congratulations.
This summer, I participated in the Miss California preliminaries and came in second runner-up in my locality.
Oh, very good.
And that's it.
Very good. Are you going to continue with the pageants?
You bet.
Well, maybe
one more time, get closer.
We'll see you one day as Miss America or something, right?
I sure hope so. That'd be great.
You're very lovely. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
You cut your cards?
I sure did.
Okay, then let's start. She had thought about that for a moment. Incidentally, we're talking about the poll. Your sister just had a baby, Jan? Little baby girl? Well, congratulations to Janice's sister. Could we send one of our polling things out to Janice's sister? Okay, there you go. See how fast we get answers to our polls, friends? We'll start the best two out of three with a question to Barrie. Barrie, we asked 100 bachelors, if a woman you were dating... Listen carefully. Think back to when you were a bachelor, Barrie.
Okay.
If a woman you were dating told you she had traced your bloodlines and wanted your genes for her child with no strings attached, would you help her get pregnant? How many kind bachelors would help the woman get pregnant?
Well, I don't know if altruism would be the true motive here. I would say that quite a few bachelors would pass up an opportunity like that. I would say that that's about a 60 would do it, I think.
60?
Sure. I think so.
60 out of 100, Carol.
No, Barry, you're wrong. I think they have their principles. I don't think any guy wants to mess around to try and get someone pregnant. Not on the majority, anyway. I think it's going to be a lot lower.
Lower?
Lower.
I thought she was going to say higher.
Nope. That's
60 and lower. I mean, if Carla checked, if Carol checked everybody out, you know. 60 and lower, huh? Okay. The actual number of unselfish bachelors who would help the woman get pregnant is 51. You're right, it's lower. Well, Carol was right. And Carol starts off the match with a 2.
Oh, make it higher. Higher.
And a 2. An 8.
Oh, freeze.
That surprised me. They were more altruistic than I thought.
Yeah.
Carol, we asked 100 people who belong to a labor union. The last time you had to go on strike, did your new salary make up for all the money you lost while you were out of work? How many union members said their new salary did make up for the money they lost while on strike?
Ooh, I wouldn't say too many did. It's the principle that they would go out on strike, but I don't think the salary's going to make up for the time they lost, so it's pretty low. I'd say about 42.
42 out of 100 say it did, Barry.
Ooh, boy, that is really tough. Could you just repeat that part for me?
Sure. How many union members said their new salary did make up for the money they lost while they were on strike? She said 42.
No, I don't think so. I think it's lower than that, Jim.
Even lower than that?
I think so.
The actual number of union members who said their new salary made up for the money they lost while on strike is 23. Barry's right. It is lower. Yeah. It's unfortunate, but sometimes it works that way, and Barry's got a 9.
Okay, I'd like to change that, please.
Winning the question... An 8.
Oh, no. Well, I'm going to go higher than that.
Higher than the 8. No, a 6. Carol, it's a break for you. A free chance to call off your middle card, the 8.
I like low numbers. Low.
Low, she says? No. Are you beginning to like high numbers, Carol?
No.
We'll fill in the spaces. Question 3 goes to Barry. Barry, we found 100 married women who wear falsies. And we asked them, why are you giggling, lady? I don't notice. And we asked them, before you married your husband, did you tell him you wore falsies? Or did he have to find out for himself? How many women said their husband had to discover the falsies for himself?
I really think that they would have to find out for themselves. I mean, how can a woman go up to a man and say, how do you do? My name's Alice and I wear falsies. I mean,
it's isn't done.
I don't think it's done. So how many
women said their husband had to discover the falsies for himself?
Yeah, I'd say 38 had to find out for themselves.
38 out of 100. What do you think, Carol?
Oh, I think that's even higher because, like he said, you know, you don't just come up to someone and say, hey, I wear falsies. I think they gotta feel you out first. It's gonna be higher.
Higher. No comment. 30 and higher. The actual number of women who said their husband discovered they wore falsies after they were married is 64. You're right, Carol. It is higher. However, I do know about half of them said the next time they're going to marry the dresser drawer. Carol, you've got an 8.
Change that card, please.
That middle card, the 8 becomes an 8.
All right, make it lower.
Lower than the ace, a 3.
Higher
than the 3, a check.
Lower
for the first game, yes! Yeah. Carol, the challenger wins game 1. We'll be right back for game 2. I wonder what the commercial is selling now after that last one. I think it's Carol is game 1. Janice is dealing out the same 2 decks of cards with the next cards off the top of the deck. Start game 2 with a question to Carol. Carol, we found 100 people who have traced their family back to its roots. And we asked them, when you traced your family tree, did you find one ancestor in your past who you're ashamed to be related to? How many people admitted they did find a skeleton in the family closet?
Oh, gosh, I'm going to have to go middle of the road for that because I know a girl from Germany just sent over our family tree, and I just don't have any idea who those people are. And I think most people in their family tree, they don't have someone who is prominent or famous. So I'll go middle of the road.
Well, we're saying someone you're ashamed of, a skeleton
right.
in the family.
I know. Well, prominent people are sometimes like that. Okay, I would say it was about 50.
50 out of 100 people admitted they did find a skeleton in the family closet.
Yeah, I think that when somebody achieves notoriety, I think that's something to talk about. So I'm going to say that it's lower than that, though.
Lower? Yeah, you don't think it's quite that high?
No, I don't think.
The actual number of people who admitted they did find a skeleton in the family closet is 37. You're right, Barrie. It's lower.
Great.
Yeah. Woo, 37. And Barrie starts off this game with a 5.
Oh, my. I'm going to play that. I'm going to go higher than the 5.
Playing it higher. Yes,
okay,
it's heavy.
Okay, yes. Good, I'll freeze.
Got through one. That's enough. Question 2, going to Barrie. Barrie, we asked 100 married men. When you first met your wife, were you in love with another woman? How many men said when they first met their wife, they were in love with another woman? Careful, Barrie.
Well, no, I know for myself. When I met my wife, I was in love with her from the start. There was no other woman. But, what, I don't know. I would say that about 32 were in love with another woman and they met their wife.
32 out of 100, Carol. What do you think?
I think it's higher because you can be in love with someone. Most people, before they get married, they've had some kind of relationship before, whether it's real serious or not real serious, but they have a certain love for somebody else, so I think it's higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of married men who were in love with another woman when they met their wife is 16. Not higher, it's lower. Barrie.
Yes.
Interesting on that one. And Barrie,
yes.
You've got a 7.
Yes, Jim, I'd like to change that 7.
Now we can get rid of that near middle card with a queen.
Oh, good. Okay. Queen, I'm going to go lower with that.
Lower than a queen. Oh, another 7.
Freeze again.
Good change for Barrie. Takes a 1-card advantage and keeps Carol away from her cards. Carol, you better get the question if you're going to get
it. Okay, here I go.
Carol, we asked 100 Catholic priests, do you believe a person can actually be possessed by a demon? How many priests said yes, a person can be possessed by a demon?
Oh, gosh. The demon or the devil, let me see.
Possessed by a demon was the wording we used.
I believe that's a fairly medium number again, but this time I'm going to go lower, and I think it's about 42.
42 out of 100 Catholic priests say a person can be possessed by a demon.
No, I don't think so. People that have problems like that, you know, a la The Exorcist or something like that, we attribute it to medical things now. I'm going to say that that's a lower number.
Lower than that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Audience kind of mixed on this one. What do you think at home? 42 and lower. The actual number of Catholic priests who believe a person can be possessed by a demon is 90. 9 out of every 10. What a fascinating poll that one is. And Carol has some catching up to do with a queen.
Oh, lower.
Lower than a queen. A 9.
Oh, I'm going to chance it lower.
She's going to chance it. No. Did not pay off. Now the question is, does the chance backfire? Because Barrie gets a free chance with a 7.
Well, I don't like that 7, but there's nothing I can do about it. But I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 7?
No.
Couldn't do it with a 3. We'll fill in the spaces. Barrie needs 2. Carol needs 3. Let's quickly get to sudden death. Barrie, we asked 100 single women, have you ever pushed a man away and said, it's not me you want, it's just my body? How many women admitted they've said that to a man?
Oh, sure. I think that happens all the time. I think women want to be appreciated. And if they feel that they're not being appreciated in an intellectual sense, they're going to say, hey, listen, I have a mind, too.
Right.
It might be hard to notice.
How many?
I would say that 69.
69 out of 100 women admitted they've said that to a man. Not me you want, just my body, Carol.
It's higher. I think it's higher because of all the reasons that he gave and because
plus several that you probably found out about yourself, right, Carol? Higher.
Yeah, higher.
69 and higher. The actual number of single women who have said it's not me you want, it's my body is 46, not higher, lower. Almost half of them, but lower. Now, sudden death. Barrie, you need 2 cards. Carol needs 4. You've got control here. Play it or pass it.
Yes, I think I'm going to pass this to Carol.
All right, yeah. Carol, you've got the first game. Get this, you are the champion, but you've got to go all the way, starting with a queen.
I'll do it. You just lower.
Lower than a queen. No, right away. Barrie wins it and ties up the match. Now, each player has one game, and we'll be right back with you, nice folks, after this. Good match, but we're out of time, so we'll play the tiebreaker on our next card, Sharks. And we would like to thank some nice people in our studio audience for coming along and encouraging us. Among them, some people from Bloomington, Indiana, and from New York, New York. Nice to have you here with us. We'll see you next time for the tiebreaker on Card Sharks.
A representative of the studio audience will receive the new Mamiya Quartz ZE 35mm camera. The computer inside is designed to make picture taking easy. For simply beautiful pictures, the Quartz ZE, furnished by the Bell and Howell Mamiya Company. And some of our contestants will receive Airways Encore 2 casual luggage. Beautiful, lightweight, and durable. With add wheels for the ease of roll-along luggage furnished by Airways. Corning plant helmets are designed to help a lot of your house plants grow bigger and healthier than clay or plastic pots. Plant helmets by Corning. A calculator and enhanced instant hair conditioner. Overworked hair is drained with its natural moisturizers. Enhanced moisturizers overworked hair. The deluxe 3-speed Regina electric broom. Never vacuum again when you can electric broom. Electric brooming is easy, light, and fast. Electric broom makes a great gift. A frying pan and Hollywood safflower oil. Higher in polyunsaturated Sonata oils. Hollywood safflower oil contains no cholesterol from Hollywood Foods.
Hi there, I'm Todd Newton from Hollywood Showdown, the game show with the box office that actually pays you for a change. Hollywood Showdown is next, right here on Game Show Network.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.